Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel, CT5K here, and today we are going to be going over the RPC2 map. When you first load the world in Minecraft, this will appear. Hello and thank you for downloading the RPC2. This world will show you how to build the RPC, and it features 8 steps on how to build the RPC2. The first step is to plot out an area. The size requirements are 12 by 14 by 5. Which is smaller than the RPC1, which was 14 by 16 by 5. Why it's smaller? Honestly, I don't know. I mean, I can tell you why, how I made it smaller and such, but I still can't believe that it is actually smaller. I was anticipating it to be larger than it turned out to be. Step 2 is to build the ALU. This ALU is similar to the one in the RPC with some modifications. And as you can see, it's a lot larger than the original ALU, but it comes with this nice feature right here, which is another input, which is another output for register A. So we can now do multiplication. So we have 2A right here, but we only have 1B. So if you wanted to say not 2A or 2A plus B, you can now do that with this computer. Step 3 is to build a decoder. I got this decoder from CraftyMasterman. And as you can see, it's just a simple 2-tick decoder. If you watched my original video on the RPC, you will know that there was a bug that would cause register 2 and register 3 to blink. And that was because of timing. So this was set to 1, and this was also set to 1, where in reality it should be set to 2. So if you wanted to go back to your RPC1, set the top repeaters to 2 ticks, and you should be good to go. Step 4 is to add ALU busing. So we have decoder 1 going to add, decoder 7 going to not, and decoder 8 going to this flip-flop, which toggles on and off the multiplication of register 1. So this design, I don't know the original creator, but I saw this on a Mumbo Jumbo video. So it's just a simple flip-flop that has an item in it. Step 5 is to create input registers. These registers can be tricky, so follow the build pretty closely. As you can see, they're very similar to the ones in the RPC. However, this register and this register are built the same instead of this one being an inverse of this one. Step 6 is to add register busing. The second input register will shut itself off as long as the value is less than the first register. So the big issue with this computer, which I hope to resolve soon, is that you can't set the first register and not the second. So when you give it an input of 1, this register will set and this register will set. You can set this register without setting this register, but you cannot set this register without setting this register. So how you will build this decoder is at decoder 5, you will place a block with a torch followed by a block with dust followed by redstone torch, and then you will go to a dust here following into this comparator. Then at decoder 4, you will have this set up to wipe register 1 and register 2. Step 7 is to create output registers. So while the RPC1 had one output register, this RPC has 2 output registers. So we have one here and one here, and the output port is still the same as the RPC1. So if you had built something with this output register, it will work the same. Step 8 is to create output register busing. This is very confusing, so make sure you follow this correctly. So this output register cannot be wiped by the decoder, but this one can. So you will build a line over here, which goes into decoder 3. Decoder 2 will come to here and then go underneath decoder 1 to allow register 3 to give it state to register 4. Then we will have a redstone torch feeding into register 4 to prevent it from filling this loop cycle. To wipe register 4, you will need to wipe it here. So you can just take a lever or a redstone torch and it would wipe it from there. As with the other map, for the Hydra 1004, I left a chest with a structure block. I also included an instruction manual in this one, in case you forget the instruction set. So, if you give it an input of 1, it will add register 1 and 2. If you give it an input of 2, it will set register 4 to register 3. If you give it an input of 3, it will wipe register 3. If you give it an input of 4, it will wipe register 1 and register 2. If you give it an input of 5, it will set register 1. If you give it an input of 7, it will not register 1. And if you give it an input of 8, it will toggle 2 times register 1. As always, thank you for watching. If you have enjoyed this video, please leave a like. Also, we are on the road to 1 million subscribers, and we have about 1 million subscribers to go. So if you enjoy content like this, please consider subscribing. As always, my Discord link will be in the description, and the world download will also be in the description. Thank you for watching, and have a fantastic day.